Hi everyone. Today in this video, I am going to talk about tranexamic acid. What is this medication tranexamic acid? This is one of the well-known antifibrinolytic, and this drug inhibits the fibrinolysis, which is responsible for breakdown of fibrin meshwork, which reduce the clotting process. So tranexamic acid is an antifibrinolytic, which can be used in the management of heavy menstrual bleeding. In few of the women, heavy menstrual bleeding can be observed which is not controlled, which may produce systemic complications due to significant loss of blood. In such conditions, with repeated heavy menstrual bleeding in the woman, this tranexamic acid can be given as an antifibrinolytic, as a tablet form, and this tablet can be used for 5 days during the heavy menstrual bleeding. But this drug should not be used before the menstruation, and it is not recommended in every woman because tranexamic acid is an antifibrinolytic, which can reduce the fibrinolysis, thereby it can increase the clotting. This may result in deposition of thrombotic plaques. So this drug is not suggested for mild menstrual bleeding. So in those women with heavy menstrual bleeding, which requires immediate attention and treatment, then tranexamic acid tablets are given. Similarly, this tranexamic acid can also be used in other conditions like hemophilia. In few of the people, the bleeding is uncontrolled because of any genetic disorders or due to the deficiency of clotting factors. Whatever may be the reason, hemophilia can be observed in few of the people. In such conditions, tranexamic acid can be given. For instance, it can be used during the tooth extraction where removal of the teeth can produce some uncontrolled bleeding, which can be treated by tranexamic acid. For this purpose, tranexamic acid can be used by injection, and it can also be used in the people with increased nasal bleeding, commonly known as epistaxis, due to deficiency in any of the clotting mechanisms. In all these conditions, tranexamic acid can be given to control the bleeding. Apart from these purpose, in few of the conditions like hyperfibrinolysis, this is a condition observed in few of the people after any trauma or surgery, where there is enhanced fibrinolysis can be observed in the people because of more activation of tissue plasminogen activator, one of the enzyme that is responsible for breakdown of fibrin meshwork. In such conditions, again, tranexamic acid can be given as an antifibrinolytic, which can control the bleeding, particularly after surgery or any trauma in the people. Now let us see how this drug acts. The normal physiological mechanism for clotting depends on the formation of fibrin meshwork. This is the basic fibrin unit, which is having one of the residue terminal amino acid, that is a lysine residue. This lysine is responsible for binding with the plasminogen, which brings the cleavage of this fibrin meshwork to inhibit the clotting process. So cleavage of fibrin is mediated by plasminogen, one of the enzyme, but it is the inactive form of this enzyme. This plasminogen should be converted into plasmin. This plasminogen is activated into the plasmin by another enzyme, TPA, tissue plasminogen activator. This tissue plasminogen activator can bind to this plasminogen at one of the site, which brings the cleavage of plasminogen such that it is going to be converted into active form plasmin. Now, this plasmin is the active form of the plasminogen, which can interact with the fibrin meshwork, and it is having the lysine binding site, which can bind with the lysine amino acid at the terminal of the fibrin. And this initiates the fibrinolysis and breakdown of the fibrin meshwork, which reduces the clotting process. This is a normal physiological mechanism which is required to control the clotting process. But unfortunately, in few of the conditions, this plasminogen activation is excessively increased, that leads to excessive dissolution of fibrin, leading to uncontrolled hemorrhage in the people. Now, in such conditions, tranexamic acid can be given. Since tranexamic acid is an antifibrinolytic, one of its target is to stabilize the fibrin meshwork. For this purpose, it is not directly acting on the fibrin. Instead, it is acting on the cleavage enzyme plasminogen. This can be accomplished by interaction of tranexamic acid with both plasminogen as well as with plasmin. This drug can bind to the different sites on the plasmin. Around 5 to 6 sites are there. Among these, lysine binding site is one of the important sites. So this site is going to be blocked by tranexamic acid. Now, in this position, plasminogen cannot bind to the fibrin and it is going to be detached from the fibrin meshwork so that it can inhibit the fibrinolysis. Apart from this lysine binding site, tranexamic acid can also bind to the other sites on the plasminogen. Among these, one of the sites is the binding site for tissue plasminogen activator. When this site is blocked, TPA cannot bind to the plasminogen so that the activation of plasminogen to plasmin is going to be inhibited. In this way, tranexamic acid inhibits the activation of plasminogen as well as it increases the detachment of plasminogen from the fibrin meshwork. Apart from these actions, this tranexamic acid can directly bind to the plasmin, which inhibits its activity. Now, the inactivated plasmin cannot break the fibrin meshwork, so it cannot produce the dissolution of the fibrin. So, this increases the stability of fibrin meshwork, which increases the clotting process. So, tranexamic acid can be given to those people with excessive hemorrhage because of hyperfibrinolysis. Now, let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of tranexamic acid is that since this drug is going to inhibit fibrinolysis, it can increase the clotting process, but in few of the people, it can also increase the risk of thrombosis because of excessive clot formation. This risk is more pronounced in those people with elevated levels of LDL cholesterol or any other risk factors like diabetes, hypertension, or chronic heart disease. In any of these conditions, the risk of thrombosis is more pronounced with tranexamic acid. So in such people, this drug should be carefully given. And particularly, the risk of thrombosis is more enhanced with co-administration of prothrombotic agents. So with such medications, tranexamic acid should be carefully given. For instance, factor 9 complex can increase the risk of thrombosis. Similarly, orally administered tretinoin can also increase the risk of thrombosis. So these prothrombotic agents may increase the risk of thrombosis when they are combined with tranexamic acid. Similarly, if you have the drugs like oral contraceptives can also increase the deep vein thrombosis. So such type of hormonal agent should be carefully combined with tranexamic acid. Another precaution is that this drug may increase the anaphylactic reactions. Since this drug inhibits the fibrinolysis, it can also develop anaphylactic reactions resulting in skin rashes. Even it can produce some difficulty in breathing resulting in dyspnea. And even it can increase the peripheral edema because of increased vascular permeability. Even it can produce some angioedema resulting in swelling of lips, throat and pharynx. Another precaution is the effect of tranexamic acid on ophthalmic system. This drug can produce some visual disturbances, particularly when it is indicated for greater than 3 months. Even this is a very rare condition. But in few of the conditions like post-trauma or surgical conditions, this drug may be used for longer periods. In such conditions, it can produce some visual disturbances. So care should be taken to check any visual dysfunction. And in such people, regular ophthalmic examination should be done. And sometimes this tranexamic acid can also produce some conjunctivitis, so inflammation of the eye. So all these points should be considered with long-term use of tranexamic acid. Another precaution of tranexamic acid with its injection form. It should not be given as neuroaxial injection because this point of administration may increase the neuronal activity and it can induce the seizures in the people. So neuroaxial injection of tranexamic acid may increase the induction of seizures. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of dizziness and lightheadedness in the people, which may impair the concentration and daytime activities. Care should be taken while driving the vehicles or working with machinery because it can produce some sudden accidental falling due to dizziness and lightheadedness produced by this drug. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. Common side effects of tranexamic acid mainly include the induction of nausea, some abdominal pain, even it can produce some diarrhea. And as we have discussed, this drug can produce some dizziness and lightheadedness in the people. Apart from these effects, it can also produce some skin rashes, allergic dermatitis because of any hypersensitive reactions. And it can also produce some hypotension, decrease in the blood pressure, which may further increase the dizziness and lightheadedness. Even it can induce the sinusitis. The cold-like symptoms are developed by tranexamic acid. Thrombotic side effects of this drug mainly include the development of cerebral thrombosis and pulmonary embolism, even deep vein thrombosis. All these are fatal conditions. So in people with any risk factors for development of thrombosis, this tranexamic acid should be avoided. Now let us the chemical nature of this drug. So this is a simple structure of tranexamic acid. It is chemically a lysine derivative, which is converted into a cyclic form. So let us give the numbering. So here we have to give the numbering to the cyclohexane from the point of attachment to the carboxylic acid. So this is the 1, 2, 3 and 4. So at the first position of cyclohexane, carboxylic acid is attached. So we can write this as cyclohexane 1 carboxylic acid. And at the fourth position, amino group is attached through the methyl group. So 4-aminomethyl. That is a simple name of tranexamic acid. But it is a derivative of lysine. That's why it can bind to the lysine binding site on plasminogen. Thereby it can inhibit the binding of plasminogen as well as plasmin to the fibrin meshwork. This inhibits the fibrinolysis and reduces the hemorrhage in the people. How it is given? This is available as a tablet for treatment of heavy menstrual bleeding, as well as it is available as injection in the conditions like hyperfibrinolysis or hemophilia. For the management of heavy menstrual bleeding, it can be given as 650 mg tablets. Each time 2 tablets are taken, given 3 times a day. So each time around 1300 mg of the dose is given. This 1300 mg is given 3 times, so total daily dose is 3900 mg. In this way, for heavy menstrual bleeding, it can be given a daily dose of 3900 mg for 5 days to control the menstrual bleeding. For the conditions like hemophilia or hyperfibrinolysis, the dose of the drug depends on the body weight of the people. For instance, for the tooth extraction, before the tooth extraction, it can be given at a dose of 10 mg per kg, given one time, but after the tooth extraction, it can be given at a same dose 10 mg per kg, but it can be given 3 to 4 times daily in order to control any unwanted hemorrhage in the people. In this way, tranexamic acid can be used to control the hemorrhage in the people with hemophilia or hyperfibrinolysis. So that's all about this drug, tranexamic acid. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.